Hi, I'm Roamy. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Ergobaby Embrace to carry a newborn using two different methods. Now here I've got the cool air mesh Ergobaby Embrace, this one here, but it's exactly the same method whether you're using the mesh or whether you're using the original stretchy wrap one. Now, first method I'm going to show you is with rolling the waistband. So you want to hold this with the kind of inside facing out. So the little kind of safety label here, you want that to be facing outwards. Okay, first thing you're going to do is roll it once towards you and twice. And what this will do is it will shorten at the panel height. Okay, so you're now going to hold that on your front. So it depends on how tall you are and obviously how long baby is, but you're going to want this to be basically around the same sort of height that baby's bottom would be. So if you imagine when you're holding baby on your front with their head on your chest, their bottom is going to be just below the level of here. So it's going to sit about there. Okay, so pass that waistband around, and if you swivel it to the front, it makes it easier to do it up. Pop it underneath the elastic and slide it in to there. Okay, and to tighten up, just pull this and pull it from nice and close to the buckle, because if you pull it from here, it'll be hard to do, but if you do it here, it's nice and easy. And then swivel that back round. And you want it to be as tight as a belt, so it's snug but not uncomfortably so. If you need to do any more tightening, you can pull that round a little bit more there. So check this is sitting evenly, so left to right, so it's sitting centrally on your body, and then you're going to pick up your baby. So I've got here a newborn sized demo doll. I'm just going to move it into a nice newborn position. So newborn babies generally will have their little knees tucked up in this sort of position, and their hands will often be up on your chest. So all you're doing is you're giving your baby a cuddle on your front with the head on your upper chest. Okay, and like I just said, you want to have their bottom either just above or just slightly over that fabric. Now I'm going to slide my hand under the material and just stroke this up very carefully over baby's bottom and back. So you're holding them with the top edge of the panel. The reason you start from down here is that means you never have to let go of baby. So by sliding up from here and bringing it up there, you're always holding your baby nice and safe. Now you want to ensure that this comes to just below their earlobe, the nape of their neck, so they've got nice clear air circulation. So if it's not coming quite high enough, just gently bring the fabric up a little bit higher. What that will do is just make sure it's baby's nicely held secure. Okay, so keep one hand across baby's shoulders. With the other, you're going to put a strap over your shoulder. Just make sure it's sitting flat across there. Then hold them with the other hand and do the same with the other strap. So each strap is going over your shoulder, and just make sure it's not twisted. It's lying nice and flat over there. Okay, so you're going to keep one hand on your baby, and then with the other you're going to reach around and find the strap on the opposite side. You grab it with the buckle, so this buckle's quite high on here, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lengthen that down, so literally just lift the buckle to pull it down. Okay, once I've got hold of the buckle, I'm going to pull the strap straight down to hold baby snug. So it's really important you do that first rather than just bringing it across, because this will hold the strap in place on your shoulder and make sure your baby's held secure. You pull it straight down first, then you bring it around, and with the hand that's holding baby, you can hold the little clip here. If you need to, you can loosen that buckle a little bit, and you clip that in here. Now, if you need to tighten it up, take hold of the buckle here and just pull it backwards. And like I said before, the closer to the buckle you hold it, the easier it's to tighten. So try not to do it from there, hold it here. And if you use your elbow to pull backwards rather than using your wrist, your elbow is stronger. So you're kind of doing that sort of movement to tighten it. So make sure this side is nice and snug before we do the other. So you're going to hold baby with the other hand and do exactly the same. So I'm reaching around, lengthening out the clip, pulling the strap straight down to hold baby snug, then bringing it round and clipping it in. Need to loosen that one off a little bit because that's a bit snug. So loosening it, literally all I'm doing is I'm just lifting that piece here to loosen it and then to tighten it, pulling that back. So loosening, lift the clip, and then tighten like that. So, most important thing with any baby carrier is you can see baby's face and they've got nice clear airways. And you wanna check they're held as tight as a cuddling arm so they can't slump. Now, if you're not sure if they are as tight as a cuddle, a good way to check it is rest your hand on the back of baby's head and just very gently lean forwards. Just check their body doesn't pull away from yours. If it does, bring any slack forward. So you reach this strap here and pull this forward like that. Can you see you've then got the slack by the buckle, and you can let go and pull that back. What that does is it tightens the strap. So I'll do the same on this one. Pull it forwards and then back This means it tightens the strap over your shoulders rather than putting their stomach in towards you. So always bring any loose material forward to the buckle before tightening. The other things to check are, again, check that you've got the fabric up to baby's earlobe. When they're older, you can have their arms out over the top. This is once they've got full head control, but while they're little, you want to have it up to here so they're supported, but I've got nice clear air circulation. Have a little feel of their legs and check they're in that nice tucked up newborn position. If they're a little bit lopsided, you can slide your hands underneath and gently shift them one way or the other. And they'll have their little knees tucked up like this. Now, obviously all babies are different sizes, so how their legs will be determined by how big they are, but they can go quite a lot narrower like this if baby is smaller. Obviously, if they're a little bit bigger, they'll be a little bit wider. So bottom ideally lower than knees with the two legs going straight down here. Hands, as I said before, are generally up on their chest like this. Okay, so that's one method of using this carrier. So the other method is without rolling it. So I'm going to show you that one now. So to take baby out, reverse what you've done. So you're going to rest your hand on baby's shoulders and unclip one side. Rest your hand on baby's shoulders on the other hand and unclip the other. And then just very carefully bring these straps over your shoulders and you can lift your baby out. Okay. So the other method of using the carrier, it is also really good if baby's a little bit tall to have it fully rolled like this, but they're not big enough to have it fully unrolled. This is a nice kind of halfway house method as well. So when baby is older, you'll wear this around your waist like this. And when the panel comes up, this will come up over baby like that. But if that's too tall, if you wear the waistband higher, this will shorten the panel. So basically, the higher the waistband goes, the shorter the panel will be over baby. And I'll show you why that is once I've done it up. So you clip that together. So I'm putting it really quite high on me here and tightening it up. Again, make sure it's sitting centrally on your body. Then I'm going to pick up my baby. Now, the reason that wearing the waistband higher shortens the panel is, can you see here, when I hold baby with the head on my chest, I've got quite a bit of this panel between me and them. Can you see that? So I've got the panel here, and then all of this is between me and them. So this means that when I slide this up over their bottom and back, this comes up to their ears there. If I didn't have so much fabric, so say I held baby higher, like that, and brought this up, it will go over their head. And if I was to hold baby really, really, really low down, I don't recommend this, I'm just showing you what happens to the panel. If I hold them really low down, this will come up lower on their shoulders. So basically, the more fabric that is tucked between you and baby, so between your body and baby's bottom, the shorter the panel will go. So you want to make sure baby's head is on your upper chest, on the solid part of your chest, and no lower. Give them a cuddle here, and then you can just have a little go and just see which height is right for your baby. So if I'm holding it here, that's going a little bit high. So I do need to hold them a little bit lower down on me to make sure they've got a nice clear airway. So slide this up and you want it to come up to basically their earlobe there. So that's looking pretty good for my baby there. So hold them across their shoulders. And if you've watched the previous part of the video, you'll know it's the same method as previously. So put one strap over one shoulder and the other strap over the other. Keep baby supported behind their shoulders. And you're going to reach round and take the strap on the opposite side, pull it straight down to hold baby snug, and bring it around. And with the hand that's holding baby, you can hold the clip and clip in there. Now I have just used this, is pretty much adjusted for me, but if you do need to tighten it, you bring any slack straight forward here and tighten the buckle up like that. Now I'm going to do exactly the same for the other side. So you're going to reach around and grab the strap on your shoulder, and you can adjust how wide it is when you pull it down. So by pulling it straight down, I can pull it down there, I can pull it down across, I can bring it there, or I can obviously use my hand here. So make sure it's sitting comfortably on your shoulder. So you go straight down and then around and clip it in. And again, this is already adjusted for me because I've just used it. Just gonna bring baby's little hand up there. So if baby's hands do get caught underneath the fabric, just bring them up to either side of their face. It means they can suck on their fists if they want to. Okay, so the key things here are, can you see baby's face and have they got clear airways? You want the carrier up to their earlobe. Now, this baby's a little bit small, I think, for this method. I think they need a slightly longer torso, so it's not quite, it's a tiny, tiny bit too high. Ideally, I'd probably use the rolled method for this size of baby, but as soon as they got bigger, I could use this method here. But you want it to go to their earlobe. You want it to feel nice and snug against you so they can't slump down. And again, a good way to check this is rest your hand against the back of the head, very gently lean forward and just check their body doesn't pull away from yours. Have a little feel of their legs and check they're sitting in a nice comfortable position. Ideally, you want to have their knees tucked up above their bottom with their knees around hip width apart. So their hip width obviously rather than yours. Just it's called an M position because it kind of looks like an M with their bottom and their knees. Okay, little hand to warm that here. Okay, and if you do need to tighten it, you can bring any slack forward by pulling this forward like that and then tightening backwards. And that brings any slack from your shoulder round to the buckle rather than putting their stomach in towards you. The straps you can spread out over your shoulders if you want like this, or you can have them more narrow over your shoulder. It's whatever you find most comfortable and works for you. So that's the second method of using the Ergobaby Embrace. To get baby out, it's the same as the previous method. So rest your hand over their shoulders and unclip one side, swap hands and unclip the other. And then you can carefully bring these over your shoulders, still holding baby. And then you can carefully lift them out of the carrier. And that's two different methods for using the Ergobaby Embrace to carry a newborn.